What we're hoping to learn is to get a better understanding of how those difficulties of social interaction are reflected in how regions of the brain are engaged during the social interactions and communicating with one another.
By mapping these areas of the brain structurally and functionally that are a little bit different in autism and comparing them to children who do not have autism, we can see where those differences lie from a neurobiological structural level.
I think it's really important to be a part of the solution and the process of helping kids that have different needs.
Pretty cool, huh? The more levels of analysis that we can get, the more we can refine those kinds of diagnoses and the better we can tailor both diagnosis, including maybe different subtypes that you might see in autism, and hopefully for developing more effective interventions.